Hello everyone, welcome to MySQL Admin Training Day 7. Today we will talk about MySQL users. I'm on the virtual machine right now and I'm connected to Linux terminal. So let me first take the sudo privilege, which is nothing but the root privilege. Now I'm connected as root. So let me go ahead and connect to MySQL instance using the root user. I'm connected to MySQL instance now. So let me first check what are the users currently created in this MySQL instance. To check this, I'll write select user from MySQL schema and the table name is user. And I have only three users. First one is root user and other two are internal users, which is mysql.sage and mysql.session. Okay, so now I'm going ahead to create my first user. The syntax is create user, then you'll have to give the username, then add, then you have to provide the host name. It can be a particular host or the range of IPs. If you'll say localhost, then this user can connect only locally. It means only from the machine where the daemon process is running. But if you'll give the range of IPs, something like this, all the IPs which are starting from 192.168, then you'll have to give something like this. Or if you want to allow all the IPs, then just give this and it will allow this user to connect from any of the IP. Okay. Then you will have to provide a password identified by, and the password that you want to use. I want to use welcome. And after that, I'll also write password expire. This is not necessary to write password expire, but if you'll write this, it means you are forcing the user to change the password on the first time when he or she will connect using this user. Okay. And the user is created, but there is no permission to this user. We have to provide the permission to this user using the grant command. So grant users is the permission that I'm going to give to this user. On, you have to provide the object name, or if you'll say star dot star, it means you are providing the permission on all the object, and users is just the permission to connect. So actually it is not going to provide any permission to any of the object, but this is how the syntax goes. But if you are giving the select permission or insert permission or any other permission, then the object name really matters. Okay, and then you'll have to give the username to admin and the complete username with the host name and hit enter. Now this user has at least connect permission. If you want to see the grants for the admin user, then you'll have to use the command. So grants for admin at this, and it is giving me the result, and the result tells me that it has only the user's permission. It has only one grant. Now in the second terminal, I'm going to connect the MySQL instance using admin user, which I have just created. But first let me take the root privilege, and then I'll try to connect this MySQL instance using admin user. I don't have to provide the host names here, just the username. And the password is welcome. And I'm connected to MySQL instance. Okay, but what if I'll try to query this MySQL instance? Okay, I've got an error which says you must reset the password using alter user statement before executing this statement. So using the alter user statement, I have to change the password before I can actually use this instance. Okay, so alter user, you can give the username here or just use a function user which will contain the current username. Okay, and then say identified by and the password. I'm gonna give my name as the password and hit enter. Now the password is changed. If you'll run the show databases command again, this time you got the result, but you can see only information schema database. because you don't have any permission on this instance, which is fine because I did not give any such grant. But if I'll go back to my first terminal where I'm connected as a root user, if I'll give another permission, which is select on DB1 schema, and the table name is test to admin, and this is the host, and if I'll hit enter, and then if I'll check the grants again for this user, I can see the select grant as well. If I'll run SOAR databases again, this time I'm able to see DB1 database as well. So let me connect to DB1 database, and if I'll say SOAR tables, I can see only test table. But what if I'll run SOAR table with the root user privilege? I can see two tables here. So as the other user does not have any permission on the other table, it cannot even see that table. But what if I'll try to run a select statement on test table? Oops. Yeah. So there is no record, which is fine, but it is able to select, it is able to run the select statement on the test table. But what if this user will try to insert a record into the test table? And it has got an error which says insert command denied to user. So which means if I've given only the select permission on the particular object, it can see only those objects and along with information schema database. And it can only use those permission. If I have given select, then it can only select. If I will give delete or insert, then you can do those operations as well. Okay. But what if I'll create one more user, which is admin2, identified by password. I'll give my name, and this time I'm not gonna say password expire. Okay, so I don't have to change the password when I will connect using admin2 user for the first time. Okay, and then for the grant, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give insert on db1.test to admin2. Okay, but along with that, I'm gonna give one more permission, which is with grant option. Okay, so by giving this permission with grant option, I'm allowing this admin2 user to give the insert permission on the test table. So if I'm connected as admin2 user, I can give the permission to insert a record into the test table to other users as well. Let's check if it is working or not. Okay. So in order to do that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna exit from admin user, and then I'll try to connect again using admin2 user. And I'm connected, and if I'll try to give insert permission on db1.test table to admin@this user, let's see what exactly I'll get. And it worked fine. So it has given the insert permission to admin user as well. So we can use with grant option while giving the grant to any user if we want that user to enable to provide the same permission to any other user. Okay, so far so good. Now how exactly I can revoke the permission from any user? Okay, so let me try this. If I'll say revoke select on db1.test from admin@, and now admin user does not have permission to select on db1.test table. So this is exactly how we can revoke the permission for any user. Now, there are many other things that you can do while creating the users. Okay. I've listed down a few here, but you can use this URL to check all the permissions that you can provide to any user. Okay, so now I'm going to create one more user here. Let me change the name to admin3. And this user I'm going to create with the permission, with the options password expire, which will force this user to change the password when this user will connect first time. And then I've also given the password expire interval 90 days. It means in every 90 days, the password will also get expired and user will have to create a new password using the alter user script. Then once this user will be created, I'll run this alter user statement for admin3 user. And what I'm gonna change for this user is, I'm gonna change the max queries per hour to 50 and max updates per hour to 50. So that user won't be able to perform more than 50 queries or more than 50 updates in 1 hour, just to restrict the user to overuse this instance and save your instance for lots of overhead because of the users. So let me copy this command first. And execute it here. Actually, I'm not connected as root user, so I cannot execute here, but let me go ahead and connect as root user. Now I can execute this command. Okay, so this user is created, but remember, I have given password expire, so I will have to change the password first. Let me exit from here. And then MySQL root and the password, what is the password that I've given? I've given welcome. So welcome and hit enter. Okay, so it says, oh, I have given the username as root, which is my bad. I'm gonna change the username to admin. Let me check what exactly it is, admin3. And it is connected now. If I'll run SOAR databases, I am getting the result back. Why exactly I'm getting the result back now? So if you'll see here, I've given password expire interval 90. So the password will first expire after 90 days. It won't expire immediately. So the user can still use this password for 90 days. Okay. So that is why I'm able to connect and I'm able to query the instance. Although I don't have any permission, but anyone can see information schema database because it's a volatile temporary database there. Okay. So what else we can do other than password expire interval? There are many other things that we can do, but let me go through the alter user statement again. And here I'm restricting the user to run only 50 queries in 1 hour and only 50 updates in 1 hour. So although I did not provide these settings at the time of user creation, but using alter user statement, I can change almost everything for a user. So let me execute this command. And now the user is restricted to run only 50 queries and maximum 50 updates on this instance. I can reduce the number of updates because anyways, user cannot run more than 50 queries on this instance, but it's up to you how much you want to restrict the user. Okay, so I can do lots of other things using alter user statement, like I can change the password. So if I'll say alter user and user is this at identified by, the password is changed. Now, if I'll say alter user admin3, and then what else I should try? If I'll give password expire, then it will expire the password immediately. Or if I'll say lock, it will lock out the user immediately. If I'll say unlock, it will unlock the user immediately. So there are lots of things that it can do using alter user statement. So if I'll say password expire, it will immediately force the password to get expire for this user. Let me go ahead and exit from here. And let me try to connect using the new password. I'm connected. And let me run a query here. And it says you must reset the password using alter user statement before executing this statement. So now using alter user password expire statement, I force the user to change the password right away. So there are lots of things that you can do. And there is a good documentation from MySQL on the users. And you can go through it. You can check all the privileges that you can assign using grant. And then there are many other options that you can use for a user in order to restrict them, in order to manage them more properly. And this link you can find in the description below. So just go through this link completely. You will get lots of information there. And at last, as I always say, thank you for staying with me on day 7. You can follow me on my YouTube channel, SQL Space Depository, or on my blog, which is sqldepository.com, or on my Facebook page, which is SQL Depository. Thank you.